legions of victory gathered in this place. We, Jothiel and Christine, greet you with all the hosts of angels who come with us, not only on the second ray, but from every quadrant and every point of the 360 degrees. Therefore rejoice, sons and daughters of God, for the quickening of your crown chakras begins with this dictation. Welcome to our hearts, beloved. We salute all angels in embodiment who have taken on the forms of sons and daughters of God to rescue the children of the light on earth. Your percentages are far greater in this organization than you would find in many upon this planet. Therefore, behold, angels of God and children of the light, behold among you also sons and daughters of God who also walk in the Christ consciousness. We are grateful for this community of the Holy Spirit. We are grateful for the sponsorship of the God and Goddess Meru and the Lord Maitreya, for this is indeed Maitreya's mystery school. Therefore, beloved, you have come to be God taught. You have come to be stripped of all those conditions of consciousness that are error, erroneous, based on ignorance or the manipulation of scriptures to hold the people in bondage. I say, let this be the day, commemorate it, and mark the date and the hour, beloved, for each year on this date we shall increase and increase and increase and intensify cosmic Christ illumination's flame, that we might bear the people of earth out of base ignorance and into the crown of glory of their own God reunion. Oh, beloved, we, the hosts of the Lord, have come with great determination, and we are matching your fervor many times over to see to it that this world shall be covered with illumination's flame piercing the darkness and the night. And therefore the quickening shall come, because you also pursue that quickening. And so, beloved, won't you be seated? Beloved Alpha and Omega have conveyed the message through us this day as angel representatives of the central sun that they are fed up with the ignorance of the people of earth, the education of the children, and all levels of education. And it is high time that you understood also, beloved, that the spiritual teaching that you internalize must be braided with secular knowledge to give that secular knowledge life and buoyancy and joy, so that the path of the yin and the yang, of the spirit and the matter in education, might become one. There are many students in the earth this day who know that they are not being fed a spiritual path, and they regret and some resent that there is not a spiritual teaching and that religion is not a part of the curricula of the universities of the world. Well, I tell you, beloved, those who hunger and thirst after divine wisdom, their throats are parched, for they have not been given the divine wisdom, even in the fields of specialization that belong to the earth. Know this, beloved, that therefore we have placed before you the color yellow, And that yellow is that you might gaze upon it in these flowers throughout this conference and meditate upon the crown chakra, for it is the opening of the crown chakra that will give you peace, absolute God peace. Therefore, let the thousand-petaled lotus rain. Let it rain by the sacred fire that you raise on the altar of being, and thus enter into the knowledge of the Buddhas. Enter into the knowledge of the Bodhisattvas, the instantaneous spherical awareness of what is and what is not, of what ought to be and what ought not to be, beloved. So I ask you in this hour, as Alpha and Omega have expressed their ultimate frustration, that there must be a focus on education, every type of education. You have established a literacy guild, and it is well, but it must cover the earth, and it is taking too long for the impatience of your Father, Mother, God, for many souls will be lost if you do not form that literacy army and make it your business to master the spoken word as taught by the great Mercurians of old. The mastery of that spoken word leads to the mastery of all fields of knowledge, beloved, and the teachers who teach have not been taught, and thus ignorance begets ignorance. It is time then that the focus of illumination's flame be amplified, for I tell you, beloved, it is most powerful, and it goes hand in hand with the flame of peace, peace in the solar plexus, wisdom in the crown chakra. Know the peace of wisdom and the wisdom of being at peace always. Know the mastery of God within you. We who serve on the seven rays and those who come also as the Dhyani Buddhas and beings of the Far East, we come therefore to this conference because we would empower those who are ready to be empowered. Thus, we of the three kingdoms who come today seek your empowerment on the second ray. Blessed ones, you must pursue it if you would have it. Let the violet flame blaze through the crown chakra. Let it purge the body. Let the mind be a scintillating fire of contact with all parts of the known universes and beyond into the spirit cosmos. Open your mind to God and see how the quickening of the crown chakra will take place. Where you have misused knowledge or wisdom in the past, perhaps using it to ends other than to the glory of God, you have a karma to pay. Pay the price of that karma. If you would be empowered on the second ray, then when you give your violet flame decrees, call for the transmutation of all misuses of the second ray of God's wisdom, illumination, understanding. The power of that illumination, beloved, shall be to each one who does pursue it as a lighthouse, as the beacon of the lighthouse flashing from your crown chakra, so that people throughout the earth may know that there is a way to reach the summit of being. There is a way to reach the place of the God and Goddess Meru. There is a way whereby the soul can rise to the level of the crown chakra, and through the rising to the heart, the throat chakra, the crown, and the third eye, that soul is day by day becoming one with God, day by day becoming more real, day by day knowing self as the allness of God, and God as his allness in everyone. We look then to education in every nation, and we say, it is wanting. There is no forward movement into a golden age of Aquarius if the twin paths of spiritual knowledge and human knowledge are not bound together, and if children are not taught from their mother's wombs and at their mother's breasts, what is the meaning of universal life? For they have come trailing clouds of glory from the retreats, and so they are here, and what do they hear? They hear the rock music, or the soap operas, or noise and more noise and more noise. Blessed hearts, every child of light who descends into this planet, born by you in your arms, every such child has been to the place of glory, and those with denser karma have been taken that they may have a peep at the realms of glory, that all might have the memory that there are universities of the spirit where all can go at night and therefore augment whatever courses they may teach in the day in the schools and universities of the world. The state of education in America is so grave that if you do not turn it around and infuse education with spirituality, you will see that ere a century has passed, so much will have been lost that you might scarcely recognize, should you return to Earth, as to what has happened with the downward spiral of it, of education. That downward spiral, beloved, is very dangerous. For as children go down and down and down that spiral, they literally lose the petals of the crown chakra, just as children lose the ability to think and to learn and to know if they are not even exercising the substance of the brain during the period of gestation. Thus you see, beloved, the stimulation of the mind begins even before conception of the child, the stimulation of the minds of the parents, the preparation of the teachers. There must be a profound spiritual path if all of the knowledge of accelerated learning that you would have is to be broadcast about the earth. It must be infused with the Holy Spirit. It must be infused with a divine wisdom. Then you will see the true balance of right and left brain. Then you will come to understand that the right brain is not only the creative brain, but also the brain that contacts the mind of God. And the left brain is in command of all responsibilities of the concrete world. Yes, beloved, a part of you is in heaven and a part of you is in the earth. And if you think that the earth alone shall provide the answers, and all who have the consciousness of the earth earthy, then go back to the Cain civilization. Go back to the place where your souls descended out of the etheric octave and descended into the place where you were no longer immortal, but mortals. Go back to that, beloved, and ask yourself in all of the incarnations you have had for many thousands of years, what have you regained of your immortality through all of the toil and the karma making, through all of the building of civilizations and the going down of civilizations? You have trod this planet round millions of times. Why? Because you have not locked into your spiritual reality. Therefore, gaze upon the chart of the I Am Presence and see for yourself the great spheres of light that surround you, all of which contain the momentums on the various paths of learning. Each and every one of those spheres represents a vast cosmos of your being, and within that cosmos, you can accelerate and become experts in certain areas. Thus, when you think upon how many reincarnations it has taken you to come this far, going up and down, making karma, balancing karma again and again, like children playing jump rope on the school playground. Yes, round and round and round and round you have come and gone. Thus the key that the ascended masters bring and that the angels of the Lord bring is the key to the integration of God in man and man in God. Man must rise to God, and man must pull down the God flame into his own being by becoming God-like, by imitating the Christ, the Buddha, and the avatars that have been sent. There must be a meshing of heaven and earth if you are to have the victory, and if you are to rescue the marvelous souls of light who can take off in their accelerated paths of learning and can then have the fusion of the spirit matter cosmos of their own being, and therefore walk the earth finally, finally again as immortals. The churches have preached of sin and condemnation, but we preach of glory and of elevation and of forgiveness and of the mercy of God that in a twinkling of an eye can erase all that is gone before in the veil of sorrow. Therefore, illumination and those who would embody it does require a fervor, a determination, and the willingness to wrestle with what you have called ignorant animal magnetism, the very ignorance and sloth of the dense mind that will not learn and cannot learn. This density, beloved ones, also goes back to diet, for what you eat is what you are. And therefore, if you would have a vessel of light, then see to it that you understand the science of nutrition that is meet for those who would be adepts on the path, not of mere human knowledge, but of all the pathways of the retreats and the golden age cities of light that are in the etheric octave and the universities of the spirit. Yes, we take you there at night so that you might see the vast inventions that will be brought forth as soon as the education is accelerated. Beloved ones, this assignment requires profound compassion. Profound compassion for those who have not been taught their three R's or their ABCs or even an understanding of what is the soul or the spiritual path. If generations are deprived of both types of knowledge, as I have said, it will not take long before the earth is lost to her cosmic purpose. I paint this picture because it is true. It can just as easily be reversed by the action of your own free will and determination to master the precepts of the law, to enter into a cosmic consciousness, and to recognize that through that cosmic consciousness, you can convey by auric emanation blessings of illumination upon those who are surely of a benighted understanding. Let all of this weight upon the planet go into the violet flame. Let all of this weight upon each and every one of you go into the violet flame, for you know above all how to invoke the flames of God and for what purpose. Therefore, I say, do it. Now I change my subject and I speak to you regarding the strides that have been made in the control of the cigarette, the tobacco industry. You will recall that I am the angel who pronounced the judgment upon that industry through Mark Prophet many, many years ago. And this nation has awakened, and it has awakened because of tremendous numbers of cancers and death by cancer. Beloved hearts, press on to this victory, spread it throughout the earth, for you see, tobacco and the tobacco entity invades the brain and the mind. Not only does it devour the individual's body, but it does devour even the soul. It is wicked, it is malicious. Therefore, take your judgment call and call for the judgment of the planetary momentum of the tobacco entities. You know that these cigarette firms are marketing their wares abroad where people are still much more addicted to tobacco than they are in the United States. Blessed ones, conquer this beast, for it is a beast, and it destroys the body before the soul has opportunity to enter in to new levels of higher consciousness. It is vicious, it is insidious, and I am well pleased that many across America have challenged this. Therefore, let us bring it to the conclusion, beloved, for the deliverance of souls from this one substance will assist them in then being delivered of worse substance, such as cocaine, heroin, marijuana, etc. All of this is the clouding of the brain, and as you know, it has gone on for decades now, where children have destroyed their brains by chemical abuse. We want to see to it that all of this is stopped, and therefore we call to the evolutions of this entire hemisphere and the world to make it a point that if all you do is to decree at the altar for the judgment of those who bring their drugs into every nation, then do it. And if you can be a part of those who physically may do more about it, then do it. For the infestation of the bodies of the people with all manner of substance that is harmful, that prohibits a full and flowering and joyous life, that cuts off their life before they have balanced 51% of their karma, and that causes them to go into the astral plane, because that is where the tobacco entity takes people when they pass on. It devours them entirely, beloved. And therefore, you must descend into those astral planes with the archangels, that you might cut free those souls who have allowed themselves to be victims. Do not condemn them, beloved ones, for when you are in a case of severe addiction, it is a tremendous burden and very difficult to be liberated. Therefore, pray for those souls of light who have become addicted, and call for the judgment of those throughout the world who are purveying these drugs, and for those in the United States who have not seen to it in all of these years that these drugs are off the streets. It could be done, beloved, and we have said it many times, but it is not being done. And what is it again? It is the ignorant animal magnetism. It is the density of consciousness from the density of the foods and from the low vibrations that people are content to live in. They live in their own sloth. They live in their own negativity, and they are not out there on the front lines fighting the battle for the liberation of the youth, beloved. Think of how many people you know, how many children of friends and family alone that you are aware of whose children have been compromised by the taking in of these foul substances. It is an outrage, and all of heaven is outraged. Let all of earth be outraged, I say, and let us join arms and lock arms and do something about it now. Legions of the second ray, join me and thank you for your standing ovation. We shall empower you as you empower yourselves. We shall go forth, Jophiel, a Christine, mighty victory, and all legions of the second ray. Remember then that the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas are also of the second ray and the crown chakra. Blessed ones, we are fierce in our determination. When you make your calls for the judgment of those who have done this to the children and to all people, remember to call our name and the names of all who serve on the second ray. As you do this, and as angels respond to your calls, you also will be empowered. The process of empowerment is up to you. You are empowered by Almighty God each time you offer your prayers for the deliverance of souls and for the mitigation of these conditions. Therefore, beloved, in the name of Almighty God, I, Jophiel with Christine, bow to the light within you, and I welcome you to the ranks of the legions of light of the second ray.